时尚名人会的焦点人物，我们真的非常的荣幸访问到的呢是全世界最会穿衣服的男人，他是 Mr.
Nick Hustard。
然后我必须要特别形容，因为今天我真的太紧张了，因为他是我心目中的 icon， 也是我的 idol， 然后我呢就是小粉丝，所以今天小粉丝要访问真的是有点紧张。那我现在就来跟他好好的聊聊咯。 First of all, I really have to say it's a big honor for me to have an interview with you, to say welcome to Taiwan. Thank you for joining on my show today.
Thank you for having me.
Is this the first time you visit to Taiwan? And could you please share your thoughts about the suit work and the reason why you support this event?
Well, it is my first time in Taiwan, and I'm very excited to be here. It's a great opportunity to bring menswear style and maybe a little New York style to Taipei.Mm-hmm. So I'm very happy to be here.
Wow, you know, so many people are so exciting to learn the news from you to will attend the GQ event this time.
I hope I don't disappoint.
where are your plans in Taiwan except for the suit work? And will you have any chance to experience Taiwanese culture?
I hope so. I mean, I would like to walk around to see a little bit of the city with the shopping, maybe a museum.It's just important to see people in their daily life, to see how they are in the restaurant, to see how they interact with each other on the sidewalk. And these are the inspiring things about how to get dressed.
But even the night market or have the Din Tai Fung dumpling.
Right, I'm going to try, absolutely.
You know, now you stay in the W Hotel. The 101 is the most highest building in Taiwan and also like in the world, okay?、
Right.
It's just next to here.
Very famous. I have the perfect view from my room. So I'm very happy with the W Hotel and the beautiful accommodation that they gave me.
And in Taiwan, okay,you are known as the best dressed style person. And however, the most Taiwanese men do not believe they can dress as stylish as you.So do you have any suggestion for everyone?
Well, I always feel like people think I'm going to give them a magic answer, but I'm afraid that I don't have one. I think what you have to do with style is try things. I think you have to try many times to see what suits you, what you feel the most comfortable in. And if you feel comfortable, then you're going to project power.
I know you every day in the morning, I heard about you have the three elements, like the weather and what is the meeting today and where you were going.
Right.
Is that right?
Yeah, for me, that's really what getting dressed is about, is you have to understand who your audience is. So if you're going to an interview or to a meeting, you obviously want to dress up. If you're going to meet friends, maybe it's a little more casual, but I think it's always important to show them that you care. So.Dress up. If you're going to meet your in-laws or go on a date, you want to make a good impression, so you probably should dress up. I guess the point is you should always be ready for anything. Be ready for an interview, be ready to meet new people, be ready to meet the love of your life. And then if you dress well, you'll always feel very powerful.
But don't you think the confidence is very important?For them.
Of course, I think, you know, but that's for me, getting dressed has been a form of confidence. So you want to find clothes that sort of say something about your personal style or how you feel. And so if you have beautiful clothes, then you maybe will project a beautiful image.
And no matter how tall you are, how handsome you are, is right.
Or how short you are or how old you are, we shouldn't be limited by physical...things, but that's important to know your body type. So if you're very tall, if you're very thin, if you're very short and maybe a little bit heavy, each of those things are not in and of themselves bad. You just have to know how to dress. It's like dressing for the weather. You have to dress for the element. You have to dress for yourself. And if you understand your body type, then you can be more powerful.
Oh, so body type is very...
I think that's the most important.
Yeah.
If you
have to realize it.
It's not a criticism, it's just understanding, it's being honest with yourself. And when you do that, then you can be free to just not worry about how you are.
Okay. I like your hairstyle.
Thank you. You know, because again, I have hair.
A little bit cute. And sexy.
Thank you.
All right. But why does aging not prevent you from staying trendy? And how do you maintain the passion for fashion?
All right, well, there's two questions there. So one is the, you know, the age, I think, is just a matter of the mind. Maybe I look ridiculous to some people. I don't know. I mean, look, I like to dress funny. I like to dress...bold, and I'm not afraid to try new things. So maybe when you get to be 55, most people think maybe that's the time to stop doing these things.
For
me, it's the opportunity to start.
Yes.
But, you know, and how do I maintain, I maintain a passion for fashion by being curious. I'm always inquisitive. I'm always trying to find out something different, what's new. If you have a sense of wonder, a sense of curiosity, you'll be well served in the world of fashion.
But we are curious, which item dictates your daily look? Pants or shirts or?
It could be any of them. In other words, sometimes maybe there's a new pair of pants, so I try to build something around that. Or it's a new pair of shoes. Or maybe it's something I haven't worn in a long time. Oh.It's like an old friend. Let's try that again. You know, there's any number of...
A serious collection.
I have a collection, for sure. And, you know, for me, I'm serious about it, but you just have to be willing to try new things.
I like your closet, you know, like you put all the shoes, you know. You understand what I mean? Like the method, okay. I think it's very, very interesting and very smart.
I have a lot of everything, but I think that when you live in New York, probably Taipei, certainly Tokyo, certainly Hong Kong, all of these places are very small, so we don't have so much space. So we have to learn how to maximize the storage.
Yeah, maximize.
Maximize.
Yeah, you're the number one, because you have the maximize closest in the world. But you know how to narrow down and put in the closet, and you have to remember, is it right?
I do have to remember, and sometimes I forget.
Okay, don't worry, because you still have a lot of new things come out. Yeah, because you know, you're just like the person, if you say, Stephanie, okay, this clothes, this coat is very beautiful. Wow, maybe they sell it out.Is that right? May I promote my fashion designer, Asina Zhuang? And my look today is good?
You look gorgeous.
Thank you, Asina Zhuang. Okay. Because we have to, you know, hold every opportunity to introduce our culture and our designer.
Absolutely.
Okay. All right, thank
Absolutely.
You. If your significant other's taste in fashion is not as stylish as you are, okay, so do you want to have anysuggestion or change them? Or you can't change it?
You can't change other people. You really can't. I mean, in English, we talk about a project, like you want to date someone who maybe doesn't have very good stuff because you think you can fix them. It doesn't work out.
It doesn't work out?
No.
Depends on everyone's personality.
But basically, people don't change. I think that's playing with fire.
Okay.
I think that's dangerous.
And men's clothing are incorporating more and more feminine elements, okay? So what is your opinion on this growing trend?
I love it. Men in skirts. I think it's fantastic.
So
why not?
You wear a lot of like the yellow shoes, but wear the...
Okay, one time I wore the yellow shoes, but that picture has like lived on... One time.
Only one time?
Yes. There were, it was at one day for Fashion Week in like 2010, in the September of 2010.
Okay.
All right. And it was being shot for GQ magazine in the United States. And it was a portfolio of what I wore every day during Fashion Week. And those pictures got so much attention. So I'm very grateful to those yellow shoes.
Not only that picture.
Wow. It was one of many, let's say. I was very lucky.
So next time you will wear orange shoes or purple shoes?
No purple. I don't like purple.
You don't like purple?
For me.
Oh, I got it.
For me. But, you know, who knows? It just was, they were a great pair of shoes.
All right.
A long time ago.
Okay. And we are pretty sure you must attend so many fashion events and fashion shows. Is there anyone impress you the most?
I think it's like asking who your favorite child is. I mean, there are so many shows, there's so many events, there's so many fashion moments that I've experienced in my life. It's hard to say this one is the most important, but I always like to think the most recent one is the most important.
All right, so too many. That's the answer, I know. Okay, and it's difficult to say which one
the is suit the suit walk in Taiwan will be my favorite event.
We are all flattered. Thank you.
Thank
Actually,
you.
I worked for GQ magazine and Vogue magazine long time ago.
Nice.
Yeah,
nice.
So I'm the colleague also, so thank you very much.
Well, thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
And thank you to Condé Nast.
And there's one more, the last question is one more, a little bit more personal question.
Okay.
We are very curious about your tattoo. Is there any story? Because you have so many very special tattoos on your body. Is it hurt?
Yeah, it hurts. That's why the leg is not finished, because it's too painful.
Yeah, right or here?
Yeah, it's just the outline. I never
finished. But you know, if you wear the short pants, wow, so cool. Outstanding. Well,
it was a moment in time. You know,
is there any story?
No.
No?
No story.
Is there any suggestion for the Taiwanese people? What kind of, like, how to dress? Or the designers in Taiwan, could you please give us some suggestion for us?
Wear what makes you feel comfortable.
All right, short and powerful. Thank you very much. And thank you very much to join my show. And I'm so happy and so exciting. Thank you very
much. I'm so excited to be here.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have you enjoyed your trip?
Thank you.
Thank you. 时尚度是无形的概念 Nick Kuster 能以此受到全球时尚界的认可，我感到无比的荣幸有这个机会能近距离的访问他。从他的微笑或轻轻的点头，我感受到他对于时尚的态度与深度，以及不费力气的驾驭能力。他说时尚带出 power， 在他身上的 power 力度真的很强大，让人赞叹钦佩。保持好奇心，持续学习，更不需要担心自己是否为时已晚，开始做就对了。